Kerrang Radio, it's Paris with White Noise. My name's Alex Baker. Welcome to the show. And right now, might sound a little bit different because I'm currently standing in the zoo area here at Kerrang Towers, which sounds like it'd be full of animals. I suppose it is in a sense because the Xcerts are here. Well done, guys. How's it all going?
Yeah, we're good. We're good.
Feeling good? You're over there behind the drum kit?
Very good, thanks.
No mic.
He's got no mic, but that's fine because that's how we're doing. So today you're going to play us. How many tunes are you going to play for us?
We're going to play four songs.
Yeah. All from the greatest album of all time, as I've currently been saying loads on Twitter, and I really mean it. You know, 2014 was a good year for music, but There Is Only You was an absolute standout album for me.
Thank you.
Hence the reason I've been playing you a ridiculous amount on the show. And also, I was mentioning this to one of our producers a minute ago. I have this habit of playing music in my earphones, and the goodness of the music has to be, it depends on the badness of the task, right? So if I'm doing something I hate doing, I listen to my favorite records.
Sure.
So when I'm hoovering at home, it's always this album that's on.
Oh, I like that. I've never thought to do that because it
counterbalances the bad task that you're doing.
That's exactly right.
Sure.
What about you? What would you be listening to? If you're hoovering, the worst time, unless you love hoovering, of course, in which case you might be listening to Spice Girls or...
Yeah, I'd probably go Bruce Springsteen, Born to Run or something.
There we
Darkness on the Edge of Town, maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe Born to Run, I think.
Huge melodies.
Yes, just me soaring through my house with the Hoover, you know, pretending I'm in some sort of dramatic cinematic
montage scene
in New Jersey. That's what I would do.
You've got the top down. You've got your Henry the Hoover in your passenger seat.
Miguel.
Yeah, there she is, looking at you all confused
Miguel.
And red. Well, one of the songs that always gets me going when I'm doing my hoovering, and I know it makes it sound ridiculous, is hopefully the first song that you're going to play for us today. It's called Live Like This.
Yeah.
Guys, when you're ready,
sweet.
Take it away. Xcerts.
Thanks, man.
Somebody stop the clock. Somebody stop the clock and see. We're gonna run into the dark. Shadow your mistakes. Oh, but I just want that crack. 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 I just want that crack.
right, folks, the song's called Kids on Drugs. I'm losing you and I'm losing my mind. But the laughter isn't important if you're not by my side. We're all stuck in a dark and black. Staring at midnight, yeah. When you cried my name and said sorry, I was terrified. What the hell is going on? We're all sunk in. I said, darling, what the hell is going on?
We're all sunk in. I said, darling, what the hell is going on? Need you to know, need you to know, this is where you belong. The kids aren't so hurt. We're screaming underneath the hurt.
Yes, go on the Xcerts. Do you get annoyed when people just call you Xcerts, or is that okay?
That's
you
okay. Down with that? We're fine with anything. Yeah. I think we quite like Xcerts.
Xcerts.
When people
Xcerts. Yeah.
Especially with in Scotland, it's Mon the Xcerts.
Oh really? Mon the Xcerts. Like Mon the Biff.
Mon the Biff. It's well, a similar like thing.
Well, yeah, no, in our own special way. Sure. By the way, that was the tightest drum roll I've heard in ages on that dude. It was just like digga 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 digga.
It's trying to be really baggy.
No, baggy at all. It was tight as. Anyway, so two great songs there from the album.
Thank you.
Well done, chaps. Lovely stuff. I can barely hear you singing it all in here, but I'm sure it sounds amazing out there. But next up, what have you got for us next?
We're going to play Pop Song.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, which was our second single off this record. Nice little pop ditty for you.
A little pop
a
ditty.
Little pop
one,
ditty.
One of the things I love about you guys is that I really do think you've got like an ability to tell stories with your music. And I know everyone tries to have that ability, but you guys have really got it in spades. So usually it's a question I wouldn't like asking, but what was Live Like This? We'll start with Live Like This. What's Live Like This actually about? What's the message behind the tune?
Live Like This, I mean, it's funny because I've never really written a song with like a kind of greater message or intent of having a message, really, apart from just me kind of exercising my own demons.
Yeah.
But with Live Like This, it was about a particular weekend in Brighton where kind of experienced a kind of like a 3-day panic attack.
Oh no!
Yeah, it was the weirdest thing. I just couldn't shake it off. It was during Great Escape Festival.
Yeah.
So I was seeing friends and
was
seeing
it
bands.
Was anxiety from like performing?
I have
what?
No idea. We didn't play.
Oh really? Oh,
yeah. Wow, okay. I was. It was just. It just came on, and I saw. Like I was just gone.
Yeah.
Like fully.
When they hit, it's hard to shake.
Yeah,
it.
And I never experienced it, and then that kind of had this kind of anxiety or anxiousness and panic attack thing or nervousness has kind of stuck around, but that was the first kind of bout of it where I was like, oh my god, what's happening? And then from that, it was basically, yeah, all about that 3-day panic attack, really.
Oh man, brutal.
So hopefully people can find something in that song. And
yeah,
I mean, you know, the line "you don't have to live like this" could relate to anything.
Yeah,
or anyone.
And not to sort of like say something that's really crass and crap after hearing such a story. When I'm hoovering, that's all I'm thinking of.
Now, when I have a panic attack next, all I'm going to hear or see is you hoovering.
Please do. It'll make you feel a million times better. I'll come and hoover your house for you, so don't have to worry about it. Yeah. One less thing to worry about.
I'll be shaking in the corner.
Shaking in the water.
Wait.
Hey. yeah. Knowledge. Okay, so what's up next? Pop song's up next. So give us a quick insight about what this one's about.
Okay, so this song is... Oh, man, it's so negative.
That's cool. And you don't have to be happy all the time.
Like, basically, I wrote it. It's a very tongue-in-cheek song. You know, this song is called Pop Song. It's one of the poppiest songs on the record. But it was basically... I used the metaphor of a pop song. The chorus line is, "You haunt me like a pop song in my head. Play too loud, I guess my devil wins again." No one got that because I just mumbled it and said it so quickly.
It sounded perfect.
But basically, yeah, it was basically about my fear of falling in love with my ex-partner, mm-hmm. and kind of cursing the fact that she came into my life because I thought it was doomed. Oh. I had like a strange premonition.
Well, that it was all going to go wrong.
Yeah, it's just like built in me that it's going to... I'll be with someone that's just going to go south.
Oh, so, mate. That is the key to loneliness, though, dude.
I know.
Don't let that live with you. The same thing where I find myself, you know, for years I was like, oh, I can't get into a relationship. And people will go, "Why? What's wrong with you? She's great." And I'll be like, "Yeah, but we'll stay together forever and then she'll die. And it'll be really depressing, you know." And that's the reason I don't have pets. Well, I do have pets now. My wife convinced me to get cats.
Oh, yeah, I have a wife. That's great.
I know. She's going to die. My cats are going to die. I'm going to be miserable and alone listening to your bloody album. Right, let's get into pop song then, shall we?
I'm just going to put a disclaimer on this. We're happy people.
Yeah.
And yeah, whatever.
Play pop songs. That's correct.
I awoke in the morning sun, I could hear dark sin. It's in your blood, it's in your guts, so don't be ashamed. So I cried out, but do I feel this way? It's not a sickness, no, the doctor did say. Still I glance towards the sun, it left me here with no one. All I've got is in your head. What she said, there'll be no fear.
are the same flesh. You are the same crutch.
This song is called Shaking in the Water.
Xcerts at Kerrang Radio, the first fresh blood session, don't you know, guys?
That's awesome.
Hand selected.
We are honoured.
Thanks so much for coming in. And as you know, I've been a massive fan of you guys for a long time. So it's great to see you in this nice little intimate surrounding in this sweat box called the Zoo here at Kerrang. Yeah, dude, you're so sweaty. It's a pleasure having you guys in. What's next, though? Because obviously you've written the best album in the world ever. So what are you going to do now? Just give it all up, right?
Just chill.
Yeah, just watch the money, just make
chill
it rain.
Hard and then make the second greatest record of all time. That, you know. Oh, and well, no.
It's going to be the
greatest record of all time.
Yeah,
it's part the second.
Two.
Yeah.
Like the greatest guitar album in the world ever, Volume 20.
We can tell everyone now, it's There Is Only You Part 2. Yeah. Same titles, same songs. It's just kind
of... two in front of everything.
Yeah. And on the front cover, instead of you falling down, it's actually you falling up, even though it looks exactly the same.
Exactly.
Because it's
exactly.
just how you roll.
You know, to the trained eye, it looks the same.
To the trained
to eye. To the untrained eye. My eyes are trained, so...
I'm Shaking the Water, incidentally, as well, for people that haven't seen the video, it's got such a cool like look to it, hasn't it? Josh Mansfield did the video of you guys. That's right.
I can't believe you just mentioned Josh
Manny.
Mansfield.
Everyone loves Manny. And it looks so cool. It's kind of like almost surf punky sort of 60s, 70s type vibe. It's got like a sepia tone on it.
Yeah. It was pretty, I don't know, like all our videos are just mistakes. Like,
what, using
honestly,
Mansfield?
It's just like, we don't have the $1 million budget to make it rain.
We don't even really have the ideas. They come on the day when we make the video.
Literally, like, we turned up in Eastbourne with Josh Mansfield and two of his friends, or three of his friends, our friends.
All the lights in the world.
Yeah. And then we were like, let's just film us kicking about Eastbourne. And for some reason, it kind of, people really dug it, which is awesome because it was a mistake.
Well, it is awesome. So congratulations, guys. I'm pleased that things are going so well. And thanks for coming in.
Thank you so much for having us.
Cheers.
Thank you.